Welcome to this tutorial about how to search for objects. In this video, we will show you a few different ways to search for objects, how to save your searches, and customize the columns in the search results. There are two views where you can search for objects. First, you can search within an object schema. In the object schema, you can use basic search and advanced search where an insight query language or IQL is used. These are similar to Jira's basic issue search and the Jira query language, also known as JQL. The other view where you can search for objects is the search for objects view, which is accessible from Insight's main menu. Let's start in the object schema view and explore different ways of searching there. First, we have to open the schema we want to search in. From the main menu, we select the ITSM schema from recent schemas. When in the schema, we select the object type we want to search within. In this example, the business service. Right above the list of objects is a filter search option, and that's where we start our search. The basic search is our default search, which means that we can use a drop-down list to set our criteria. Let's find all business services that have importance high. To do that, we first select importance, the attribute we want to filter by. Then we select the value to filter by and click on update. By updating, the object list will be updated to match our filter criteria. To verify that we only see objects where the importance is high, we can change the view from detail view to list view. To do that, we click on the detail view icon and switch to list view. When in list view, we can also configure the columns that are displayed. So let's update the columns to show the importance column. To do that, we click on the columns button, find the importance attribute, select it, and update. Now let's switch to the advanced search to view the IQL query behind the search we just did. Searching in basic search and then switching to advanced to see how the IQL looks like is a very good way to learn the basics of IQL. When we have the basics, we can add a more complicated twist to it to narrow our search further. Some searches can only be done through the IQL in advanced search, like reference searches. Let's take an example. We have the importance filter already on from our basic search earlier, but let's add to it. Now we want to find all business services that have importance high and are running on the server MySQL prod app 7. Because the server is a reference attribute, we need to add the following IQL and object having outbound references name equals MySQL prod app 7. If the object type we are searching within have inbound references that we want to search by, that is also an option with the IQL. The options we have with the IQL are numerous and some quite complicated. The best way to learn is to practice and read the documentation about IQL. Now let's move over to the search for objects view and check out our searching options there. In the search for object view, you can search with either IQL or free text. Free text will search the text of all objects and object attributes for relevant strings or texts. It does not search in attributes that are not text fields. Let's try a free text search. First, we have to select the schema we want to search within. In our case, we will select the ITSM schema. Then in the free text, we write MacBook and hit enter. The results will give us all objects with MacBook as part of their name. If we have a text string MacBook in any attribute in the ITSM schema, it would show up in the list. Let's move on to the IQL search. We looked at IQL earlier when we searched within an object schema. The difference here is the autocomplete feature. Having the autocomplete makes the IQL a lot easier. Let's take an example. First, we need to switch from free text to IQL. If we continue with the example we have taken before and look for all business services, We start to type object type and get a drop-down of all suggestions and select object type. Next, we add the equal sign and automatically get a list of object types. We select business services from the list and hit enter. With that, we get the desired results. To narrow the search further, we can add to the IQL query. Let's add another criteria and find all business services where Bia is the business service owner. We start by adding and to the query and then biz to get the select list where we can select business service owner. Again, we add the equal sign and select Bia's name from the list and hit enter. When we have the results we want, we can save the search for an easy access later, or to use in an inside widget on the Jira dashboard, or to share with other users directly with a link. For all the search results in this view, we can configure the columns we want to see on the screen. To edit the columns, you click on the Columns button and add a checkmark to the columns you want to display. In our example, let's select the columns for status and service category, and then click Done to save the settings. Now we have a list of all business services that Bia owns, displaying the columns that we want. We have seen several ways to search within Insight, so let's recap on what we went through. First, we searched from within the object schema, where we have a basic search and advanced search by using IQL. Then we moved over to the Search for Objects view, where we can search by both free text and IQL. In the Search for Objects view, you also have the option of saving and sharing your searches for further use. In both views, you can configure what columns you want to display. This concludes our tutorial about searching in Insight. Thank you.